Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey everybody, it's Carly Lee with Bringing the Smoke. Today I got the working line German Shepherd. Today I got my boy Marcos from MBK9 with his two working German Shepherds. Traits genetically hardwired to the German Shepherd are intelligence, eagerness, loyalty, working hard, obedience, protective, and a well-bred German Shepherd is going to be a very good-looking dog. If you think you may want a working line German Shepherd as a pet, you should be energetic, active, and be able to provide a structured environment. A working line German Shepherd is fierce but friendly and has a calm confidence that may seem kind of aloof. However, a working line German Shepherd is instantly ready to protect, play a game, perform a task, in some cases, as a guard dog, police dog, herder, or even a CNI dog. In terms of size for the working line German Shepherd, the males weigh about 66 to 88 pounds. The females weigh 49 to 73 pounds. As far as height, the males can be anywhere from 24 to 26 inches. The females, 22 to 24 inches. Today we have my boy Marco from MBK9. So Marco,
hey, what's up?
How you doing?
Good. I'm blessed.
Hey guys.
Hey Marco, thanks for coming out. What dog did you bring out today?
Thank you for having me first. Well, we got my 8-year-old female German Shepherd Marley, and then we got our my puppy, 9-month-old Atos.
Marco, how'd you get into the German Shepherds, and specifically the working line German Shepherds?
Well, it started as a kid. You know, my grandparents and my parents owned like German Shepherds. So it just started from there, and I just fell in love with the breed, and just carry on through those days.
So you have working line German Shepherds?
Yes, I do.
What is the pedigree, and where do they originate?
Well, they originate either from West Germany or East Germany, but my two dogs, in the background, they have a Czech line, especially in the puppy.
Man, I can feel that. What's your thoughts on the show line German Shepherd, and would you think you would own one?
As a pet? Yeah, probably one day, and maybe we'll own one, for the work that I want to do, and they're not really what I'm looking for. But they could make a good pet for somebody that, a family or somebody that wants to take the dog for a hike and stuff like that. They're great dogs, sure.
What do you see the difference in the working line and the show line German Shepherds?
Well, the main difference is probably the physical aspect and the drive, the difference of drives in the dog. You know, the show line is slightly bigger dog. They have like that, their back angle is okay. it's sharp. Okay. In the working line, they're a little bit more straight, slightly smaller, but more muscular, good for stamina and speed.
Packing a punch.
Yes, but definitely the drive, the prey drive that they carry, it's way different, you know.
Of all the protection sports, Marco, what made you choose IPO?
I like the three phases of the sport. You have tracking, obedience, and protection. And I think the obedience part, it's must be a very high level of obedience, and that's what I like. You know, I like the most. The tracking part, it can be time consuming.
just a little bit.
You know, just a little bit. Early mornings, and things like that. But then you have the fun part for me, that's the protection part.
My favorite part.
Yeah, that's when you come into place.
My favorite part. The exercise I did today was back setting his grip. I worked on a little sending. And then most important, the bungee work. With the back set grip, when the dog is on the chain, I'm working on the dog understanding how to strike at a grip and have his body behind him. The dog has to learn how to develop his mouth. The only way he can really learn how to develop his mouth is with a back set. In the wild, the puppy is on the other side, the opposite side of the hide. He would be the back set naturally. Since we don't have this, I use the chain. The chain gives the dog the ability to strike with his full and complete body, but his jaws being able to hold on to the prey. As a decoy, all we are doing is mimicking the wild. When the mother wants to see whether or not her puppy is developing in his grip and understanding what she's teaching him, she brings the hide back. When she brings the hide back, puppies, several puppies around the hide, they're grabbing, they're pulling, they're all pulling in their different directions. So that's a natural back set, where the dogs would be pulling against each other, the counter. The mother pays attention to this. The ones she sees biting with the harder grip, those are the ones that go hunting first. So I'm only trying to mimic that. I don't have a counterbalance of being a puppy, so I use the chain as the reinforcement to his body as a back set. That's all we're trying to do as a decoy, is to mimic the carcass, the rag, the hide. But when I'm working on the send, is the dog actually learning how to run correctly. Basically stride now, like wind sprints. The dog has to learn and stride out. He doesn't understand how to run. Just like a track star has to develop a stride, a dog has to develop a stride. So at a young or early age, after doing so much back setting, I know where the dog is coming. I know where the grip is coming. So now I let the dog stride out to the grip. When I'm doing bungee work, the bungee works on the dog's entry. Entry teaches the dog how to work, come in on a striking grip with his body maintaining the speed. You know, they're moving at 30 miles an hour. So the dog got to learn how to run in at that speed and grab the prey. The bungee helps the dog understand and regulate and slow down the speed. So now when I let the dog go free, me as a decoy, I know how to catch the timing. But the bungee is truly teaching the dog to really grow at a stride, in the sense of teaching them power. Power. I like to train the striking grip because no matter what, when the dog in the wild only gets one opportunity for one grip, he might get one grip in real life, what we call the wild. And if he don't get that grip correctly, that could be his ass. So the dog gotta have a striking bite. That's why any dog I train, decoys will tell you, I train striking grip, not come in and grab you. It gotta strike and grab you. It's a big difference. Hey, this is Kari Lee. I'm wrapping up another session of Bringing the Smoke. Today we have my boy Marco from MBK9. He brought out Altos and Marley. Thanks for coming out, Marley.
Thank you for having me.
Appreciate
it. It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Oh man, it was my pleasure. See y'all later.